Hello, and welcome to this tutorial from InQuality, where we'll configure an AEQ Phoenix codec for use with the sip.audio service. First of all, we'll open up the Control Phoenix software, select the appropriate codec, click on Config, and then General. Next, we can change interface to SIP proxy-based, and then click the IF Setup button, followed by SIP Parameters. We want to manage proxy SIP accounts and add a new account. Here we'll put sip.audio for the account description and again for the proxy provider. Enter the username of the sip.audio SIP account, which we'll be using for the Phoenix, and anything for the display name. Again, we enter the same sip.audio username followed by its password. And for the realm, we'll enter again sip.audio and then click on Apply. Close that window and then we choose sip.audio as our SIP account and we say yes, we want to assign it. Next, we need to add a proxy provider, so click Manage Providers and New Provider. Enter in here sip.audio for description and for the host we'll put proxy.sip.audio. You can probably leave the SIP port the same, and for the domain put sip.audio, and then click on Add. Close that window and then choose sip.audio as the proxy provider and click Apply. Under NAT traversal, assuming you're behind a NAT, we found that Auto 3 worked well for us. It's not possible to enter stun.sip.audio in the AEQ Phoenix software, so instead we need to enter its actual IP address. Right now it's 46.37.165.198. Click Apply there and apply again. Under Advanced, apply audio profile to incoming calls and apply. Under Select Codec, you can then choose the appropriate opus setting for your calls, mono or stereo, as you see fit. You can close this window off now, and then you can try calling from your SIP device or application at the other end. We're using ipDTL here. Now, it's important to note that the Phoenix will only support specific bit rates for opus, so either use 128 or 64 or another fixed bit rate which the Phoenix is happy with. Enter your SIP address for the Phoenix device and try calling it. You can see the calls coming in now and we can accept the call. And as you can see here, the audio which we're sending to the Phoenix Alio is appearing in the receive meter in ipDTL. And also the audio which we're sending to ipDTL is arriving back at the Phoenix codec. Thanks for watching this tutorial from InQuality. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to learn more about sip.audio.